Bonjour tout le monde. Je tiens tout d'abord à remercier le Premier ministre Lee Hsien Loong d'accueillir le ministre Carr et moi à Singapour. As a country built by trade and strengthened by diversity, Canadians understand the importance of looking to opportunities beyond our borders and working with like-minded countries to build a more prosperous world. This very productive visit to Singapore has been a chance to further that commitment, strengthening the ties between our two countries. Singapore is one of our most important partners in Southeast Asia, an ally on security and defense, and a key partner in forums like the Association of Southeast Asian Nations and the World Trade Organization. And we're not just united by our work on the international stage, but by our people, too. Across Canada, people celebrate their Singaporean heritage, and thousands of students from Singapore study at Canadian schools every year. This close relationship between our two countries has always been forward-looking. There's no better example than the thriving collaboration between our entrepreneurs, including some of the 150 Canadian businesses that have operations in Singapore. Over the last few days, I've had the chance to meet many of these innovative leaders who are helping set up Canada for success. And I've also seen firsthand what kind of great results we can expect from the new comprehensive and progressive Trans-Pacific Partnership. Just a few weeks ago, Canada formally ratified the CPTPP. Getting this deal done was a top priority and part of our plan to grow the middle class and create new opportunities for working people and entrepreneurs alike. As one of the first six countries to ratify this deal, Canada will be at the front of the line to reap the rewards of this agreement when it comes into force at the end of this year. And our government is focused on continuing to build strong ties that create an economy that benefits everyone. Just like in past years, my third annual Leaders' Dialogue with Premier Li of China was an opportunity to keep working together to grow our shared prosperity and open new doors for Canada to the world's largest market and its second largest economy. Whether our government is taking action on trade diversification or investing in skills training for students, we're supporting Canadian entrepreneurs so they can succeed and grow their footprint here in Asia-Pacific markets and around the world. This visit was also an opportunity to strengthen Canada's relationship with other countries throughout the region. At the ASEAN Summit, I met with Southeast Asian leaders to work together on building prosperity for people from Jakarta to Vancouver. For Canadians, that means expanding trade with countries that share a coast on the Pacific, which includes some of the fastest-growing economies in the world. Over the past few days, we moved forward on exploring the potential for an ASEAN-Canada free trade agreement. Because just like recent agreements signed by our government with the European Union, the U.S. and Mexico, and the CPTPP, we understand that international trade creates new middle-class jobs for Canadians and supports the businesses that are driving our economic growth. As you may have heard me say a couple of times over the course of this week, we are the only G7 country with free trade deals with all other G7 countries, and that leads to growth and opportunities for Canadians. Je tiens donc à féliciter Singapour pour un sommet réussi et productif. C'est un plaisir d'y participer et je sais que cette visite nous permettra d'amener notre partenariat avec les pays de toute la région de l'Asie-Pacifique à un autre niveau.